I formed my first production company, along came a woman by the name of Roberta Lee, and she said, would you like to shoot this series? And we said, yes. And then she said, they're children's shows and they've got to be made using puppets. At which point I nearly vomited on the floor.
What was extraordinary was how primitive the setup was.
Okay, this is very simplistic, but we might just as well make it as well as we could.
And I was suddenly introduced to this mad lot of people who let me have a wonderful time
playing with puppets. And at the end of the week, they pay you money as well.
They were real pioneering days.
We just went from one series to another, and it always got better. We don't want any of those puppets anymore. Nobody realised we were making history.
As much as we could, we were bringing big film techniques to the little screen.
We were the stars of the children's programmes.
The children that used to collect outside the doors, any minute it opened, they were all these faces all sort of staring to get in.
And he said, Gerry, this is not a television series. Gerry, this is a feature film.
Now we were at Leicester Square. We'd hit the big time, boys.
This is the place where it all began. How does it feel for you guys to be back here?
Weird.
There was certainly amazing pioneering work done here, although it all seemed very Mickey Mouse at the time.
Well, there aren't any limits as far as we're concerned. Nothing is impossible in the special effects.
But the most outstanding commercial success of all in television puppetry has been scored by Sylvia Anderson and her husband, Gerry.
The technical fascination of seeing model characters and model machines behave in a realistic way on the screen.
Far be it from me to interrupt, Parker, but what is supermarionation?
I was just getting to that, m'lady.